What's up, you guys? You know how bummed it is not being able to work on my car, being one-armed bandit. But I had another really exciting thing for me related to the GTI, which was uncovered yesterday by a post. I guess I'll explain all that. On the Mark 7 forums, there's one guy, and maybe Jeff Jones, I don't remember. It's Mark, mymark7golf.com or something. You know the guy, if you've ever been to that forum. He does all the super technical tests on airflow, right? And all the inlet elbows, all that stuff. That's one reason I still have my Unitronic. That was one of the highest rated. But he just released a test yesterday of the new speed IS38 front mount intercooler flow rate. Got to be very specific here. Nothing to do with temperature drop, only flow rate, okay? And that's only half the picture on intercoolers. But nonetheless, let me tell you what he found. He found that the new speed intercooler that I have, flow rate itself is less than stock. That's a straight up statement. It's proven. It wasn't a skinny margin where it just sneaked by. It was very obvious. So that doesn't necessarily off the bat mean the intercooler is junk, okay? And I don't claim to be an intercooler expert. I haven't studied the dynamics and technical stuff for that. I just know that an intercooler has two main components, flow and cooling, okay? All related to like the plate design, the bar and fin and plate. And however that's designed is gonna determine your flow and your cooling. And as far as the more obstructions in the flow, the more cooling, because the air slows down and it sits on those obstructions longer, dissipates heat. It's all a big puzzle, but in a nutshell, let's just be honest, the new speed intercooler flows a lot less. And that completely connected with the logging experience we had recently. Remember when I just did my logs for Unitronic? And remember that post? Everything makes sense now. Remember that post? He said something in your intake side of your car is just really clogging things up, is really holding things up. And he was real focused on the ducting and intake. I didn't buy that myself, and it turns out I was right. But then again, Unitronic didn't know much about the new speed intercooler, so they wouldn't know what was going on that. But it turns out that my wastegate cycle at 30% or whatever you call it, on all my runs is because of a little stuffed up front end, like the car has a cold, which is because of the new speed intercooler, okay? And it is still installed right now, don't get me wrong. But I was just thinking, what can I do on this? What are the plans? What's the most cost-efficient way to figure this out, get around it, get past it? And I figured it out. At first, I was thinking of ordering Treadstone makes a good kit. I'd never heard of Treadstone. Maybe you haven't either. But a guy that I have a lot of faith in his knowledge, Mr. Andrew Bowers, he's been around since the Plas days back in Mark 6. He knows me well. I know him well. And he has a high horsepower GTI. And he is deep into the technical. So I definitely trust things that he says. And I hate to admit it, but most of the time he's right. So he mentioned a Treadstone intercooler is good. I then did a bunch of Google on Treadstone, and I found that it's good. It ain't no Garrett, which is the cream of the crop. Probably costs double too. But Treadstone is a good intercooler. It's used across many brands, okay? So just to get to the point, they had a kit, a GTI kit, ready to go. For about $600, something like that. And that's what I was first thinking is, All right, I'm just gonna buy either a Bond Performance or a Treadstone kit, $750, whatever, and change my front intercooler. I still have no intention of going with a stock mount intercooler, just so you know. I'm not gonna do that. I don't even want to do that. So the next thing, then I said, okay, so I'm gonna take out the new speed intercooler. I'm gonna try and sell it. All this news is released. Bad time to sell a new speed intercooler, right? And the funniest thing in the world is this morning I checked in on the forums and there's a new speed intercooler for sale, just like mine. I made a little comment in that post, by the way. I was all, funny timing, isn't it? But so how am I gonna get by that little obstacle there, trying to sell something that recently had a couple bad news posted about it? Well, it makes perfect sense now. What I'm gonna do, and here is the master plan, guys. So super stoked. I am going to remove the new speed intercooler, right? Only the intercooler, not all the accoutrements. One of my favorite words. Not the SAI, secondary air injection pump relocation brackets, not the horn relocation brackets. I'm just gonna remove the intercooler and keep all the extra brackets. And you say, well, you're not gonna be able to sell that thing as a kit then. Well, yeah, no crap, exactly. So for cost efficiency on how I'm gonna resolve this, I can sell it somewhere local easy. I'm gonna sell just the new speed intercooler itself, the piece of metal. I'm sure I can get $200-$300 for it, easy. And without the custom brackets and all that. Now, I don't need the custom brackets for this car with what I'm gonna do, I'm about to show you. But I'll probably take them off just so someone has an idea how to get the brackets working. Although they'd only work on a VW. But that's my workaround for trying to sell the new speed intercooler that might not be so desirable these days. I'm just selling the piece of metal. It'll be someone's custom project, right? A custom project, something like that. And what am I gonna do? I am going with, you could call it, one sec here, you could call it a Bond intercooler if you want. I am going with a Vibrant 12810. Supports up to, I think, 500-600 horse. I'm gonna check all the details later. I honestly, off the top of my head, do not remember. But the next size up from 12810 is way too big. It's like 600-700 horse. It's a waste of space, honestly. So what I plan to do is order this intercooler for $198 to improve my intercooler system. And figure out somehow, I'm gonna have to get custom stuff if it doesn't bolt up. And I'm gonna take measurements of the width, 30 inch, including the tanks. Once I have my bumper off and the new speed off of the car, take some measurements. And this comes with brackets to mount it somewhere. And the real question is gonna be, will those new speed hoses mount right up, or it'll be a little custom deal? But the best part of all that is that it can be a slow process. I can use my stock one in the meantime. It'll be connected. So it'll just be a slow build, just trying to get the last pieces to get it to work. But now you can see for $200 more, I'm going to get a proper cooler. One of the top reputated brands, Bond Performance, who has really good cores that he uses. And definitely a better core than what I have now. So what I plan to do is put this in place of the new speed, keep everything else the same. And as I said, if the hoses don't reach, I'll have to find some custom pipe hoses, figure that stuff out, not the end of the world. But it'd be nice if it bolts right up and I instantly get twice the size intercooler, a lot better flow, and what that company considers the best for a stage two. And then, so we circle back to the new speed sale here. I know I can get at least $200 for it. That's covering my cost right there. So there you go. For basically free, I can get a much improved intercooler, twice as much capacity. I'm sure twice as much cooling even. There's twice as much surface area on this thing. I don't have the exact specs yet. I will be getting that for you a little bit later. But that is the plan. Now you can see how bummed I am with the one-armed bandit. I want to get this going. I want to get off that intercooler. I may try and one-arm it. The only thing I can think of, which is difficult, is moving the bumper with one arm because it's wide. But aside from that, slow and steady, I got nothing to do all day long. It's 9 a.m. I can just slowly piece that apart, get the stock hoses back on the cooler, and while the bumper's off, take my measurements before I order this, of course, and just see if it's going to fit right and get some ideas on that. Start planning out my next install. So that's it. I'm very excited, even though I can't do much. So I'm going to get to work on this. Just wanted to keep you guys updated on a solution that I found that I think is a pretty dang good solution. Cost me almost nothing. So that's it. I'll see you guys later. I'll keep you updated as things come along. But I'm going to try and get this going a little bit right now.